Morning, everybody. Miss Portland, I'm super, super proud of you. It takes a very, very strong person to do what you did, especially when you knew that the hate was going to come. And to everybody casting hate, shame on y'all. Y'all totally used this woman for y'all's agenda, for y'all's entertainment. You filled her head full of stuff, gassed her up to where she would be attacked, and y'all loved every damn minute of it. I tried to tell her this, but I've learned that sometimes all you can do is state your opinion and then let the person know. Now, when everything falls apart, I'll still be waiting on you, but I can't take this trick with you. And Miss Portland, that's nothing against you, honey. I've been here before. I personally have never been affected by any of these people because I don't give a shit. They can talk all they want to, and it just makes me smile. Don't care. And that's how I wish everybody would get. But I understand everybody's not like that. So, Miss Portland, I'm super proud. I'm proud of your new teeth. I can't wait to get mine done. I was in the middle of them, and then my stepdad got COVID. And I also got sick, so I got to get back into the dentist. Get my teeth fixed, too. But, boy, yours is super pretty. But other than that, I'm just so proud of you. You'll see that you will rest better. You will have better days, better nights. Everything will be just so much better now that that hate is gone. And to people saying that they're back to get, you didn't watch nothing. Y'all really, really need to start doing some homework. I mean, shit, it was said over and over that the apology was accepted, but for right now, it's best not to bring her back over to the channel. So how y'all gonna say she's back over there? There's like a probationary period here to see if they're gonna, to my understanding, now I'm neither one of them, but to my understanding, they both decided to chill, not to be coming on each other's channel, just to try to prove to each other that they can be peaceful. That's my understanding. Now, if you need it out the person's mouth, you need to go find them. But I think it's kind of unfair that there's channels right now saying that Miss Portland's back over there. She's done. No, she made amends. Some people don't want to live all hate-filled all the damn time. I hope some of you that's talking shit about this right now see this, because whether you like it or not, I care about you. I don't have to know you to care about you. And I see you going down a way road. It's just way wrong. It's a way wrong road that I've seen numerous people taking, and it don't end up well for anybody. So I hope you open your eyes too and quit trying to make people feel bad because they finally saw the light. Now again, Miss Portland was being, she was so being used. And then, just like I told her and everybody else, when they're done, they will cast you to the side. And that's what they did. They was tired of talking to her. So they said, they used, we don't want you to be a target. They already made you a target, honey. That ain't why they quit talking to you. They quit talking to you because you didn't benefit their story anymore. They took it another direction. I don't see why other people can't see it. They send people in there into other channels to be trolls, to where their ass will get chapped, they will get chewed out, and then they come back and then start 2 weeks rave and rant and rave about how so-and-so was so mean, but I see through y'all. Y'all play games. I don't play with y'all. That's why I don't get caught up in this shit. I don't care. It means not shit to me. But I'm proud of you, Miss Portland. And everybody that's naysaying on it, shame on you. And to the ones that just said the N-word and mocking prayer, wow. Oof, I'd hate to be you on Judgment Day, honey. Because blasphemy is the unforgivable sin. That's on you. That ain't on me. The N-word, not cool. I don't care if you do claim you put K's in it. I don't care. Like I said before, you take that shit one-on-one with a grown-ass person where they can beat the living hell out of you, because that's what happens around here. I am so, so lucky to be in a very, very, very integrated town. Now, up here in Terrellville, it's not as much as Gastonia, but I am so glad that I grew up like that, because we learned respect for each other. We play together. We fight together. We fight each other. And then we make up together. Hell no, that word wouldn't come out my hood. So y'all do better. The R word? Now I get it, because I'm a kid of the 90s. My mama used to say that to us all the time. But today's meaning, it's not a good thing to say. I personally am not offended by that word, because I was born in 79. We've heard that word over and over to describe as being stupid or being ignorant. But that N-word, I'm going to get you hurt. But just be grateful, Miss Portland, that you out of that. See, you could have been there during that. And God don't like ugly, and he don't like blasphemy, and he don't like making fun of prayer. He don't like making, boy. You better hit them knees for that one, girl. So, again, Miss Portland, super proud of you. Just because we made amends don't mean we're best friends. It don't mean we're going to be over there. It don't mean none of that. It just means that we have made a decision within ourselves to live differently than you, to have a better life than you, to feel better on the inside than all y'all that's just filled with hate and everything is negative. And y'all are imploding, man. I had a friend ask me, she was scared of making amends. If I make amends with somebody, I'll lose my subscribers. No, you won't. Look at all them channels. Ain't hardly none of them got 1,000 subs. You want to know why? Because they're circling through the same ass haters. All their viewers and their subs are the same. Most of them won't see 1,000. Because they have to take turns going live, because they have the same fan base and it's not much. A lot of people don't want to live like this. Okay, last thing I want to say is to Hebrew Hammer operators. Hebrew, I don't want to say that I'm hurt, because I'm really not hurt. I'm just kind of mind fucked. I really liked you, but now I really just pity you, man. For you to be doing the things that I've seen you do, you have to be really, really dark on the inside and really miserable. And the same offer I gave to my friend when she decided to self-destruct, and that I gave to Miss P when I had to cut her off. Hebrew, I'll be here when you're done with this shit, because you're going through something, honey. I see it. I've spoke to you about it. So I'm going to just let you go do your thing. But when you're done being so miserable and so hate-filled, or your friends have cast you aside. Hold on a minute. Isabel, that's my carpet, homegirl. Better take your hooking ass out. Don't you look at me like that. Anyway, Hebrew, I'll be here. So when you ain't got no friends, when you're tired of living this way and you go to make your real amends, because I don't know if they'll be accepted, but I know you're better than what you're doing. So reach out to me. My phone number don't ever change. It's been the same for 9 years. You got it. Email travississy@gmail.com. Just reach out to me when you're tired of it. I'll be here still. And I've proven that with my friend and with Miss Portland. I'm not going to ride this ride with y'all bumping ass the whole way, because I've done hit my rock bottom. I've done bounced off mine, and I'm fine. I'll ride with you until you decide that you knocked your own wheels off. Then I can't ride no more because you're destructive. You're destructing yourself and everybody around you. But when all this is out and you have a change of heart, reach back out to me, Hebrew, because I spent a lot of time talking to you. And I don't know, I just got a soft spot for you, Hebrew. So when you're done playing all the games and everybody's turning their back on you and they're tired of your childish shit, reach back out to me and we'll see if we can start this again. I'm not going to go down in flames with you, but I will sit on the sidelines in case you want to climb your ass back out. I will give you a hand to get out. So, everybody do better than yesterday. Everybody behave. And I'm going to get off here. Bye, y'all.